Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. My name is Laura and today I wanted to take you through some of my favorite thrifted items. So I've talked about thrifting or going to op shops a few times here before, but sometimes it's just really awesome to see some of the things that you have actually managed to find through doing that. And some of these are some of my favorite items. I do have additional things that I have bought secondhand, but they're not my super favorites, or there's other things that I want to talk about that I actually got from thrift stores or from op shops, as we call them here in New Zealand. So I hope you enjoy today's video. Let's get into it. All right, number one is this woolen blanket. I got this for $10 about a month ago. I saw the colors and I was just amazed. And oftentimes these blankets are humongous, like full queen bed sized, and $100 to $200. So when I saw this, it said it was a small single, but when I looked at it, this is so perfect for having over you when you're sitting on the sofa, or for me, I get colder than my husband does, so I put it over like my side of the bed at night to help keep myself extra warm, but it doesn't warm him up. This is such an awesome size, so pretty, and it was $10. It was just amazing, and I checked it over for holes. Oftentimes it'll have little moth holes or something from over the years, but this is in perfect condition, so I was so happy with this. The only problem is that my dog really likes it. So I think it will forever have some dog hairs embedded in it because I think he's trying to claim it as his own. But this is just the cutest thing and could have easily been like $200 for a nice wool blanket if you buy from like a secondhand dealer. The second one, which was technically from a person secondhand rather than an op shop, is actually this dress that I'm wearing right now. Sure, I'll show you a few more details. This I am going to be wearing a lot more as we get into warm weather. So this is just like a super comfy plaid. It's almost like a linen feel. It has pockets. It's so gorgeous. And I've seen these in stores like Flo and Frankie, similar dresses, for again like $200. And I think that this was $25 secondhand. So there are some pieces that you can get out there secondhand if you know what you're looking for and you have a bit of flexibility on like timing and the specific requirements, that you can get for such an awesome price. So yeah, this is probably my favorite dress right now and I'm so glad that I got it for such a good deal. Some of my other favorite thrifted items are in the kitchen. So I have these four Temuka mugs that I really, really like. Two of them have handles, the other two do not have handles. I've seen the ones without handles described elsewhere as like spoon holders. I don't care if these are spoon holders. I use them as mugs and I can just hold them in my hands and they are amazing. So I think each of these mugs was like $4 or something, but I just, these are so cute and they're just so satisfying to hold and I just really, really like these mugs. And they're so good. The other thing that I've gotten, which is kind of similar, is bowls and plates. So I have two of these little dessert bowls that are again in that like really vintagey brown color. These two are again Temuka, and you can see on the bottom that it has the Temuka stamp. And then I also have these plates. Now I was so sad, one of these got broken the other week. So I did have four of these to show you, now I only have three, so it's quite sad. These are not Temuka, they're just a random pottery brand from the UK, but they are so pretty and they look like a sun to me. They look like sunshine plates. And again, they've got that really nice texture to them. They're not just super, super shiny. And I love using them. I am very happy to get rid of all of my other plates and just keep these. So yeah, again, amazing thrift store find. I think the set of these plates, the four of them, when I got all four of them, was like $10 or something. So awesome price. I also have a few different big kind of mixing bowls. I think that technically these are all like oven dishes, you know, you mean to like cook stuff in them in the oven or put them in them to like serve them on the table. I use them for mixing stuff. So I have two of these similar white ones that are vintage Pyrex, and my mum actually has a similar pattern to these. That's how I knew about them. So I've got this kind of medium one, and then I also have a larger one, which was in the wash. And then I have this big oven dish, which is also Temuka, right? You can see a theme here. So again, this is meant to go in the oven. Once upon a time, it would have had a lid. the lids get broken from these so easily. So I've never actually really used these in the oven. I use them as mixing bowls and I really like them. The other item that I technically got secondhand, but I've seen very, very similar in thrift stores or op shops, is this single stool that I bought. So when I bought it, one of the four supporting bits that goes between the legs was missing and I replaced that myself by hand. So I use this just to put plants on. I maybe wouldn't trust it to sit on just because I did repair it, but this was $5 and then I restored it with stuff that I already had for other projects. This is so cute and I really love it. So if you are looking for stuff, particularly if it's just to like put plants on rather than to actually physically sit on, keep an eye out because there are many of these items that are a little bit damaged that are going for really cheap. Okay, this one's pretty random. This is my one silver candlestick. I got this last year on Black Friday sales, but it wasn't Black Friday. So a bunch of the op shops here were doing Green Friday, where instead of going out and buying a bunch of stuff brand new, which is typically what you do for Black Friday, right? This was super specials that they were doing to buy stuff secondhand. So in this one shop I went into, they were doing anything for a dollar. So I got this Walker and Hall silver candlestick for $1 and I was so happy with it. So this is when I was looking for little vases for stuff for our wedding and I got rid of a bunch of the ones that I'd got for the wedding. This one I kept because it is so cute. So it's just up here on my shelves with the little bunny ears in it. It's my one candlestick. You meant to have them in pairs, right? I just have the one. That's okay. Speaking of shelves though, the other thing that I thrifted from the ground, and I've told this story before, so the property that we're in is a group of units and at one end of it there was this broken fence and like no one was addressing it for years. And I realized that the wood that was just laying there on the ground from where the fence had broken, they were not going to use to rebuild the fence, but I could use to make some stuff out of because it was still really good, solid, treated wood that wasn't really decaying. It was just there getting this gorgeous patina and aging on it. So I picked up this giant plank, walked it to our house. My husband said no and I was like, just you wait, this is gonna be great. Cut it up, cleaned it all down and everything and turned it into these shelves. And I'm so happy with that. So this is again, just a little PSA. You will be surprised what you can get for free, particularly if you're like asking on community groups, if anyone has some like old wood that they're not using, that kind of thing. There's a lot of stuff going. And I think that this just adds so much nice character to our house. I really, really like it. So my free shelves that I thrifted from the ground. Again, in the kitchen, I have some silver spoons. So I have 3 teaspoons and 2 big spoons. Josh does not like using these, but I really, really like them. I basically don't use other spoons now. So each of these, I think, was like a dollar from an op shop somewhere, and I collected these over a little period of time. But I just love having these, and I would love to actually get all of our silverware, all of our cutlery, to be like this, but my husband just likes plain, like, you know, stainless steel cutlery. So I don't think that that's gonna happen, but I just love having these in the drawer. I use them, I love the shape of them and the feel. They're just so good. They're so satisfying. That's just me. All of these frames that I have on the wall of my picture wall, which is the one day that I'm not sitting in front of it. So all of these frames that I got basically, except for the 2 square ones, the 2 little square ones, because I could not find square picture frames in the op shops. I tried for so long, I just needed something square to kind of balance it out, couldn't get them, but all of the other ones are thrifted. So most of these were not in this condition when I got them. I had to either paint them or I had to sand them back and then retreat the wood, but you just get so much nice variety compared to going to like a Kmart or a warehouse or a Target or whatever it is that you have close to you and getting these just like MDF ones, right? If you can get something that's actual proper wood and then make it your own, you know, treat it so that it's like a light beachy color or like a dark rich color, like whatever it is that you want to do with it, you can do with something that you get from the op shop for $2, particularly when it comes to these artsy things that you actually want to have a bit more character for. Totally worthwhile. Josh's desk. This one has a little bit of a story to it. So 3 Christmases ago, it was a little while ago, we did a little trip to Hamilton, which is south of Auckland by a few hours, and we went on like the 20th, 21st of December, and it was a weekday, right? So we went for a little trip and I wanted to hit the op shops there to see if there was any furniture that I could get, and this was when I was big into my furniture flipping. So we rocked up at this place where it was two op shops next to each other, and apparently there were some of the best in Hamilton, and we were like, great. Got there and it had said online that they were open, and they had signs up saying that they were closed from like that day until like January or something. So they were gonna be closed for like 10 days. And so they said, don't drop anything off here because no one will be here to collect it, yada yada. But some people had dropped some stuff off. And in the stuff that had been dropped off, that no one was gonna be able to be there to like collect and take into the store for like 10 days, was this gorgeous little desk. And so I looked at Josh and I was like, we should just take it. Because either we're gonna take it or someone else is gonna take it, because no one's actually here to take these collections. And generally with op shops, you're not meant to just leave stuff there, right? You're meant to take it in when the store is open so they can actually take it, right? So someone had already left it there with that. And then again, no one was gonna be there for 10 days. So we just took it. It only just managed to fit in the car. And I feel so ashamed. I feel like those builders who never actually finished their house, right? But this has been in our house for probably, at the very least, like 18 months. And I haven't done anything to it. I've cleaned it. That's it. I've cleaned it. I have not refinished it. So it is exactly as when we bought it. But it is so good. It's so practical. It's so nice just having a little desk when you're in a little house. It's just perfect. So this sits in Josh's trumpet room. He very kindly kind of cleared away all his music so that I could show you guys it. I also keep some of my DIY tools in there because we have no other little drawers anywhere. We have none except our kitchen ones, which are very much being used because there's only four of them. I'm so good at numbers, four of them. So I keep my brushes in one of them and then I keep my little other tools in there. But this is just the cutest desk, and I will actually have to get around to refurbishing it soon. Maybe I should show you guys that. Maybe I can show you guys that. Okay, ideas. This is good. Another thing I got, which is just a little thing, but I see it every day and it's really cute, is this little terracotta pot that lives in our toilet room. Not in the toilet, but in our toilet room, which is very tiny. So again, in our toilet room, I have a little shelf that I made out of that broken wood that I took from the ground, and it's so cute. And then in the corner here, I just have this little terracotta pot that I got from a thrift store for like 50 cents. And because it's older than the ones that you get brand new, it just has more character to it and more kind of mottling on the side. So I really like it. I really like the texture that it adds to this room, particularly when you have those concrete blocks at the back of it. It starts to look a little bit prison-ish. Having this really nice texture is just really great. And I think it goes really well with the little cactus that it's got inside too, so. Last but not least is this gigantic cookie jar. So I got this only a few months ago from Junk and Disorderly in Mount Eden. That's Junk as in J-U-N-K, Junk and Disorderly. If you've never heard the name of the store before, you'd be concerned. So I got this from Junk and Disorderly for $8, I think, and it came with this ginormous big cork that fits in it. I love it. Josh hates it. There's an ongoing battle here. The only thing he does like it for, which is what I'm putting in it today because that's what I made this weekend, is English muffins. It's so perfect for that. It's just such a cool big jar, and I know that buying big jars like this brand new is like $50, so I'm so stoked with this, and I think it just adds so much character. It does live in the pantry, unfortunately, so no one really sees it, but I think it's really practical and awesome. So that is everything for today. Honorable mentions will include my trusty lamp that is behind us. This was a secondhand off-trade one. I didn't show you guys it because A, it wasn't technically thrifted. It was from a person secondhand. B, it's not finished. This was the first thing I started and is also not finished. And see, the lampshade doesn't fit it properly. So if you come into our house at any other time, this lampshade is like on an angle somewhere because it doesn't sit properly. I'm really impressed that it didn't fall. I was not meant to admit that. I got it before this video to fix it. Anyway, we move on from that. So thank you so much for joining me today, guys. Please comment down below if you have any items that you have thrifted that you're really, really proud of, that you really love, and tell me what those are, because it's always so nice to hear about those things that you find that you just really enjoy having that you got for an awesome price and also save the planet from buying a new product. And it will also probably give me inspiration on what to look out for in the future and what I know are good items that you can find in thrift stores or op shops and get secondhand. So thanks again for joining me today, guys. Please subscribe if you enjoyed my content. Comment down below what you'd like to see more of in the future. And I will see you guys next week. Take care. Bye.